I've been to many closing ceremonies as an athlete and as a fan. I've never explored the process that prepares and delivers this symbolic performance. I'm here behind the scenes to discover more.
So Carlos, you run the costume department.
Correct.
Leading into the closing ceremonies of the PM Games. And so what does the closing ceremonies mean to you?
Closing ceremony, you see 10,000 athletes out there on the field of play hugging each other. Why? Because they've realized there's no boundaries, there's no podiums, there's nothing. It's just them celebrating, and this is what it's all about. It's about Toronto, it's about the city, and it's about sport, really.
Tell me some of the numbers around the ceremony.
We have something like 600 different costumes, 1,600 pairs of shoes, different pairs of shoes. So we have 41 different countries, but 41 different looks. We have up to 40 volunteers working with us non-stop every day, props and costumes, but at the end it will culminate in something absolutely fantastic and worth your while.
One, center up.
Nice and strong, please. Don't move around.
Hold them nice and strong for me.
Good. Okay, stand up.
Peter, you're the creative director of the closing ceremonies of the Pan Am Games. What challenges have you faced leading up?
Oh my gosh, so many challenges, but all of them fun and exciting, and all of them creative, and all of them needing to be approached in a creative way. And you're seeing our choreographer stepping the cast through that to perfectly align the elements of that cardstock. You're also seeing another group of dancers rehearse one of our production numbers, so there's so many pieces that have to be rehearsed separately and then folded together. It's a puzzle, really, but a wonderful puzzle that when it finally comes together in one piece, you go, ah. Look at that.
Thank you, Peter. I appreciate the
time. You're welcome. My pleasure.
That you gave us, and good luck in the last few days of preparation.
Thank you so much.
7, 8, and oh, ha, ha.